Good evening, doctors. Our today's topic is about premature ventricular contraction. We can say another word is PVC. It's premature ventricular contraction. On EKG means ECG, electrocardiography, we see sudden high amplitude ventricular contraction noted on. Here it's QRS isolated and normal sinus rhythm. What was going to happen here? We see there is a ventricles which is works excited dramatically due to high amplitude ventricular contraction occur in the Purkinje fibers, or we can say bundle of His. That's why there is premature ventricular beats occur. What are the findings? Findings in normal patient we see such PVC, premature ventricular contraction. In case of post MI patient also we see on ECG. Sometime a patient taken digoxinate's toxicity and recurrent premature ventricular contraction lead hypotension. So, my dear friends, see, diagnosed by taking history of medication, maybe he is taking digoxin which causes premature ventricular contraction, or we see some electrolyte abnormality or so many medicines that causes premature ventricular contraction. Symptoms, we see the palpitations, but not regular palpitation, irregular, not like as in ventricular tachycardia. See the biggie money, I am going to explain you now ECG about premature ventricular contraction. See, this is why biggie money, because PRS complex normal, then there is premature ventricular contraction here, then QRS complex normal, then premature ventricular contraction, it's 1 and 2 by, that's why biggie mini, then 1 and 2 biggie mini, need to treat this situation. If asymptomatic, no need to treat. If symptomatic, need to treat. Okay, then trigemini, see normal PQRS complex, then T wave, then normal PQRS complex, then there is premature ventricular contraction here. It's known as, see, 1, 2 by, and then is trigemini after 3. Yeah, this is not severe condition. Then quadrigemini, see, 1 PQRS complex, 2 PQRS complex. Okay, it's only tri here, so I'm going to draw here. It's looking like P QRS normal complex and T wave, and then P. So see, 1, 2, 3, 4 quadrigemini. So I hope you understand this situation is less severe, so not required treatment in case of quadrigemini. See, here PQRS normal, then T wave, then see what happens here. It's different amplitude, isolated. It's premature ventricular contraction here, and here different premature ventricular contraction means different side defects. See, this we say multifocal premature ventricular contraction, different shape on ECG, that's right, it's multifocal. Okay, now see the treatment in case of premature ventricular contraction. If it is asymptomatic patient, no complaints, no instability, its hemodynamics are normal, like oxygen saturation, like blood pressure, like respiratory rate and his pulse, so no need to treatment cross. If patient is post MI, means already having MI episode, myocardial infarction, he is hemodynamically stable, then also we need to give beta blocker like propranolol IV infusion. In US, in USA we can give IV infusion. Okay, if patient is unstable and biggie mini, which I already explained what is biggie mini, we need to give IV amiodarone. Why? Because sometimes there is tachycardia, BP rises, so amiodarone doing work by what? It's lower down the BP and lower down the pulse rate. So my dear friends, we need to give amiodarone that time. Sometime in cases of premature ventricular contraction. I hope you understand this lecture. If you have any queries, any questions, you can ask me. You can see ECG on your practicing also when you are going to see some cases of premature ventricular contraction. I am watching these premature contractions in ECG monitors directly in ICU. So my dear friends, have a good day. Thank you for watching my lecture. And if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. Have a good day. Goodbye.